This is LXBN TV, and I'm Colin O'Keefe. Last week, the Illinois Senate and House passed a bill that will soon make their state the second in the country to have a law prohibiting employers from asking employees for their credentials to social networking sites. To explain the law and how it could potentially inhibit legitimate business activity, we bring in Philip Gordon, chair of the Privacy and Data Protection Practice Group at Littler and author on their blog, Workplace Privacy Council. Phil, as you wrote, the new law contains two main prohibitions. Can you explain what those are and the activities those apply to?
Gladly, Colin. So the first is a prohibition, as you suggested in your introduction, on an employer's requesting or requiring that an employee or job applicant provide login credentials or other passwords for a social networking site. And that restriction is pretty clear. The second restriction prohibits employers from demanding in any manner an applicant's or employee's login credentials or social media site. And it's unclear exactly how that second prohibition supplements the first when the bill says demanding in any manner. I don't know if that means, for example, that an employer cannot ask an employee to log into a restricted social media site without actually sharing his or her login credentials with the employer so the employer can look over the employee's shoulder, called shoulder surfing, to see what is on the restricted site. That's not what the bill says, but it might be what the bill intends to accomplish. We still don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's going to be interesting to watch. I mean, this is, of course, the second interview that we've done on a law like this. We spoke on the Maryland law previously, and you seem to be, you know, somewhat opposed to laws like this as they have the potential to inhibit legitimate business investigations. Can you explain how the Illinois law and others and ones like it create obstacles to legitimate business activities?
Absolutely. So this is my concern. What happens, for example, if an employee comes to HR with a complaint saying that he or she saw something offensive or potentially indicating a risk of workplace violence or misappropriation of trade secrets on a restricted social media site? Now, for example, let's say an employee posts, "I'm so angry, I feel like I can blow the place up today," or I'd like to go onto my employer and shoot the place up. And in today's world, those types of comments have to always be taken seriously. We've had too many tragedies in the workplace for employers to ignore those comments. Now, with laws like those in Illinois and Maryland, it's unclear how far employers can go to get access to the actual post to confirm the report that's received from the coworker. And even that uncertainty can create problems for employers. It could create a delay when time is really of the essence. I just think right now the law, in terms of employers' responsibility for employees' off-duty social media conduct, is too uncertain and too undeveloped to put these types of restrictions on employers. There was, for example, recently a case out of the California Court of Appeals where the court affirmed a jury verdict against an employer for constructive discharge and hostile work environment, and a substantial portion of the evidence involved blog posts, off-duty blog posts by coworkers of the plaintiff who was the former employee and felt that he was being harassed by coworkers through this off-duty internet activity. Now, in that particular case, the internet activity was not restricted access. It was publicly available. Unfortunately, these laws do recognize that publicly available social networking content is fair game for employers. But if in that case the post had been on a restricted access site, it's unclear whether the employer still would have been considered responsible for them.
And lastly, do you see there potentially being some kind of happy middle ground where employees can trust their personal online accounts are protected while employers can access them when legitimate needs arise? What's the best way to find this happy medium where I think employees can have their privacy and employers can conduct legitimate business investigations if the need arises?
It's a challenge, to be sure. The Maryland law suggests that there is a potential middle ground because that law has exceptions for investigations into securities fraud violations or suspected misappropriation of trade secrets. In my view, there's no reason to distinguish between those two forms of workplace misconduct and other types of workplace misconduct. So what I think would be a happy medium would for the exception to be when an employer needs information on a restricted site to conduct a legitimate investigation into suspected misconduct related to work. And the statutes can be written to put the burden on employers to prove that their request was the result of a legitimate business investigation. And I think it's important for legislators and applicants and employees to keep in mind, I think most employers are skittish about accessing restricted social networking sites, that employers understand that there is a lot of information out there that they cannot lawfully rely on for business decisions, for employment-related decisions, and that generally, they're going to ask for login credentials when they have a legitimate business reason to do so. And I think the law should recognize that there are circumstances where an employer does have a legitimate business reason.
It's going to be interesting to watch going forward. Of course, Illinois and Maryland are just two states who have already started this. Many other states are in the process of putting these into place. And it's going to be interesting to watch not just as these laws go into effect, but as these laws, you know, things happen under these laws. There's litigation under these laws. So it's going to be interesting to watch going forward. Once again, that was Philip Gordon of Littler. For more on this story, be sure to visit their publication. He has some excellent, excellent insight on laws like these at privacyblog.littler.com. And of course, we have tons of commentary on this subject. Just do a search for Facebook passwords and click on that tag at lxbn.lexblog.com for a ton of insight on this. Thanks, Phil.
Thank you very much, Kyle.